I want to thank everybody for coming out. I know on both sides of this issue, there is a lot of passion, and that is fantastic, no matter what side you're on. And I appreciate everybody coming here to get a little bit more information. This is an informational meeting. We are not looking for a debate of any type. We will open it up, let you have questions or comments, any of that. But this is, the intent of this is to be information. So the information that we are providing today comes from what we've been able to collect so far. We are not a professional organization. We do not have full-time staff. We are, just as you, neighbors in the community that heard the initial announcement of this, said we have a few concerns, and started looking into it a little bit further. Just as a brief introduction, my name is Ross Bruno. I spent weekends and summers up here with family for my entire life, and I guess it's been 3 or 4 years ago, moved into a house just up the road here on County Road 64. So, Pam, do you want to introduce yourself?
Sure. Hi, thanks, Ross. And again, thank you everybody so much for coming out tonight. We really appreciate it. I'm Pam Jacobus, and my husband, Myron Morrow, and I have lived in this neighborhood for almost 30 years. He has actually lived in the Bailey area for, well, since the 70s. I can't think of, can't count how many years that is. Say hello, Myron. Hi, honey. We are now retired, but I worked in Denver at Fort Logan Mental Health Center since 1982 as a psychiatric nurse, and Myron had his own drywall business up here for many years in Park County. He's probably worked in and on most of your homes at some point in time. So that's who we are. So thanks again for coming.
Thank you, Pam. Since first getting word of this project on August 8th with the state meeting, we've been trying to collect information. To be honest, it's been tough to get information. You know, they are still in the process of it, and as such, they don't reveal everything, and that can be understood. But what we've tried to do is gather as much information we can. To my knowledge, there has been no town halls in the community to give us information on this. So the information we have is based on that August 8th final action memorandum, the minutes from that, the Colorado Open Records Act, which, if you're not familiar with that, basically a government entity or any person can ask a government entity for information. There are a few exceptions, but they do need to reveal information to you. For the past 5-6 weeks, the community here has absolutely bombarded the state with those requests, and this is the CORA document so far, 400 pages and counting. We got several more today, so it is a lot of information. Some of that information is on the back table. We tried to cut it down for you so you can see the main elements of the campaign or of the project going on. It hasn't been edited in such a way that, you know, to be misleading or any of that. We went through the 400 some pages of emails and cut out the, hey, how are you? I wanted to check back on this. You know, just the quick things. If it has to do with the plan, it's in the book back there. You're welcome to take a look at it. If any of you want to make requests of your own to the state, you are able to do so. So if you have questions about this and you want to put it into a little form, it's a one-page form that we've got for you, or it's available on the website, absolutely ask the state. It's your information. All you got to do is ask for it. So as far as the structure of the meeting, again, this is an informational meeting. What we're going to do is walk through the informational packet that you were all given, and if you don't have one, they're on the back table there, and we can certainly get you one, or raise your hand and Sally can grab one. Got one more for Gary. For Gary. We're going to walk through this, and then Pam is also going to come up and talk about some of the concerns that have been expressed to her today. Then we'll open it up. You can ask some questions. We have limited information, but if we can answer it for you, we will. If not, still ask your question. We'll write it down. We'll see if we can find that information. If you don't feel comfortable asking that in a public setting, we did set up an email address, and you're more than welcome to just email your question. We'll see if we can find the answer. So with that, let's go ahead and start looking at your packet here. Just past the cover there, you'll see the agenda. It's very short. I talk a lot, but it's very short. So after those five items, we will open it up to the questions. There are some people here that have submitted letters to the state as of now. We will allow them to get up and speak if they feel they would like to. Do not be offended. I may kind of wave at you. And that's just to keep things moving because we've got a lot of people in the room that may want to ask questions, and we'll just keep it moving forward. So after the agenda, we've got a short overview document. And there are two things I want to point out on this document. First of all, there are two elements to this proposal. First is a not-for-profit effort with 50 to 100 kids coming up during the week for educational and, I guess, outdoor, I guess, familiarity. And there's, I'm not sure how many weeks out of the year they will do that, but it's 50 to 100 kids per week, max. The second element is a for-profit adventure and obstacle race with anywhere between 300 and 10,000 people coming over the course of a weekend, okay? Those are the two elements of this proposal. From the information we've been able to collect from the open records, the not-for-profit activities do not have funding at this time. If that's changed, we'll absolutely update you guys. But as of now, that funding is not available. That element of the proposal only happens if the 10,000 person events happen. Okay. The next nine pages are the bulk of what we're going to go through, and I'll let you kind of peruse that at your own pace. I know it's a lot of information, but there are some key things I want to point out there. First, this was created and presented by the State Land Board. It was not by this community, it was not by the company that is submitting the proposal. This is by the Land Board. Both the education camps and the adventure races are proposed. Approval of this proposal will not be limited to educational efforts alone. Okay. Development of the site will take it away from agricultural and wildlife habitat to a campus that, from what we've been able to tell, features more than 20 buildings, a 3.1 mile by 8 foot wide track that will have obstacles as well as parking on that campus. In addition, we've got information that those buildings will be used for overnight stays and or activities, as well as primitive campsites. For those that are not familiar with McArthur Gulch, on the second page, there is a map, and it shows you it's about a mile from here, just to the east. And you'll see that access is limited to County Road 64. Old Stagecoach Road is shown on that map, but it will not be allowed to be an access point for this property. The company has asked for a 30-year lease on this project. This traditionally, the state land board limits theirs to 10 years, to my knowledge. But due to the development of the property, they're asking for 30. Acceptance of the proposal will require cancellation of two existing leases. The first is an agricultural lease that has been in existence for 60 plus years. The other is a Colorado Parks and Wildlife lease that allows public access. From August 15th to May 31st, anybody in this room can be on this property, as of now. Once those leases are canceled, the public access ends. And on the final page is the recommendation. I'll read it verbatim. Based on the information presented at the August 8, 2014 board meeting, staff requests that the board direct staff to complete negotiations with Human Movement Management for a 30-year recreation lease on the 480-acre McArthur Gulch parcel located in Park County, including the cancellation of existing leases on the property. One thing from that statement that I do want to note is that recommendation is for the lease by Human Movement Management and not an affiliated not-for-profit company or anything else from the proposals we've seen thus far. At this meeting on the 8th, the board did accept this recommendation and put negotiations into place. That does not mean they're completed. That just means those negotiations are happening today, yesterday, and tomorrow. As you can imagine, this project has raised some concerns. The information we've been able to collect from the final action document that we just looked over, the open records documents, as well as HMM media statements to date, are a little bit confusing. They were for us, they likely are for you. Sometimes even contradictory, but as this process goes on, we will continue to look for confirmations, clarifications, all of that to keep the information going. Truth is, this is our community, and if this is beneficial for the community, we want to hear it. If it's not, we want to stop it. Next few pages of the packet are letters of concern that have been presented to the state land board, including a letter from the Park County Board of County Commissioners, which Pam will go over in a little bit more detail in a few minutes, as well as Park County Sheriff's Department, Platte Canyon Fire, Platte Canyon School Board, and the Colorado Backcountry Hunters and Anglers. And finally, after your letters there, there's a one-page overview. Feel free to take a look at it. And the How Can I Help page. We'll go over this in a few minutes after Pam gets a chance to stand up and talk. That, I'll turn it over to you, Pam.
Thanks, Ross. Thank you. And again, thanks so much for coming out tonight. Before I begin, I'd like you all to remember that the proposal information we're referring to tonight and which has been referenced in all of the letters of concern is actual communication, either directly from the state land board's own public website or between Human Movement Management staff and the Colorado State Land Board staff, which has been provided to us through my request for documents through the Colorado Open Records Act. The document we're going to be reviewing is, that's a lot of papers, I know, the letter of concern from our own Park County Board of County Commissioners to the Colorado State Land Board of Land Commissioners about the Human Movement Management McArthur Gulch proposal. Our Park County Commissioners say that no direct notice to them or consultation with them preceded this action by the Land Board. They have outlined their concerns about this proposal very clearly in their letter. First, the access to the property is insufficient for the proposed level of use. Access to the property is provided solely by Park County Road 64, which is a dirt road maintained by the county for only local travel levels. The addition of travel for events of up to 10,000 attendees would require massive additional repair and maintenance at the expense of Park County and its taxpayers. Park County is not willing to undertake this additional level of expenditure. According to the actual email correspondence from HMM to the State Land Board, HMM stated that we may even be able to get the county to cover costs for roads, additional roads, if they're for fire safety, necessary, etc. It would be a private road. Our commissioners write that this statement is entirely untrue. Park County will not build any additional roads to facilitate this use of the McArthur Gulch property. Second, even putting aside the maintenance and repair issues, existing roadways are inadequate to handle the volume of traffic which will likely be generated by the proposed use of this property. The proposed parking field for 5,000 vehicles is far beyond anything currently existing anywhere in Park County. And this number of vehicles would undoubtedly paralyze traffic in the vicinity. Some of you probably saw the article in the Flume. That article is also in your packet, I believe. The comparison in size between the proposed parking lot in the HMM emails and the parking lot and Invesco field. The proposed on-site parking is 37 acres, enough parking for 5,000 cars. Invesco field parks 6,500 cars. The Board of County Commissioners goes on to say that even that vast parking field is apparently inadequate for the scale of events proposed. HMM has stated that additional parking and shuttle service for events will be available at the nearby Platte Canyon School campus. This statement is also untrue. HMM has never even spoken with the school superintendent, much less secured permission to use the school's parking facilities. Third, the proposed use of the property, as we understand it, will require one or more conditional use permits from Park County. According to the BOCC letter, there has apparently been no investigation by HMM into whether the proposed use meets the criteria for a conditional use permit set forth in Park County's land use regulations. The Park County Planning Commission and Board of County Commissioners will fully and fairly consider any application by HMM for a conditional use permit or permits because that's their job. But it is difficult to see at this juncture how some of the criteria for such issuance of conditional use permits will be met. Fourth, under current Park County regulations, the conducting of any significant outdoor event by HMM on the property would require a special outdoor event permit issued by the county. In light of Park County's recent experience with major outdoor events this past summer, like the one y'all might have heard about at Safari Ranch in South Park, our county commissioners have suspended the issuance of such permits pending the adoption of new regulations governing them. The specific regulations will be drafted in the next few months and will be in place by January 1st of 2015, but it is likely that they will severely restrict or even prohibit the types of events contemplated by HMM on properties such as McArthur Gulch, which are located in or near residential areas. Fifth, pardon me. Park County did not receive any, I've got some, thank you, any notice that the state land board, intended to consider this proposal at their August 8th meeting. Nor does there appear to have been any public participation, perhaps because most of the affected neighbors were unaware of this proposed lease. Ross mentioned at the beginning of this presentation how difficult all of this information has been to obtain. This point by our county commissioners emphasizes that fact. They go on to say that even though the notice of this potential action probably complied with the requirements of the Colorado Open Meetings Law, we also believe that the courtesy of specific notice to and consultation with the direct stakeholders within our community where this major development is proposed would have been appropriate. Sixth and finally, emergency services in the vicinity of this property are clearly insufficient to handle events of the size contemplated by this proposed lease to HMM. In your packet, there's also a letter from Platte Canyon Fire elaborating on that fact. So in summary, our commissioners have expressed clearly that there are numerous problems with the proposed HMM lease of the McArthur Gulch property, some of them potentially insurmountable. Thank you so much.
This time, I'd like to take you back to that final page of your packet about how you can help. We've had that question come up several times over the last few weeks. I'll give you kind of a quick overview, but take the packet home. That's your reference. First thing, back here on the table, there's a petition asking the state land board to set aside the August 8th directive until further information is available. Right there on the table, tonight's a great night to sign it. Second, share your information. All of you here got some good information tonight, probably more than you've been able to collect so far without doing CORA requests and so forth on your own. If you left your email address there at the table, we will get you an abbreviated version of this packet that you can share with your neighbors. Share it around. Next, send your letters. First one there on top is the Colorado State Land Board. Got the names of each of those board of directors right there on top. They do not have individual emails available to the public. What you do is you email Melissa Yoder there, or you can send it by traditional mail. We also suggest that you copy these staff members, Bill Ryan, Tobin, Greg Oches. Those are there. Those are staff members that are directly involved in this project and the board of directors that are directly involved in it. Second page there are our own Park County Board of Commissioners. They need to know what you feel about this. We've let them know. We've talked in front of them. Pam's always up there, so. And I know from what Pam tells me, a lot of you have been up there as well, expressing your concerns. Keep it up. Write them letters, write them emails, whatever you can do. Lastly, or I guess not lastly, next. Governor Oates oversees the state land board. He appoints those commissioners. If you don't believe they are living up to their responsibilities, he's the one to tell. His information is there. You access him through his own or through the website, and right there is the link. Congressional districts. I won't go through each of those. Number four and number five are information that we've been able to, or I guess are recommendations we've gotten through the experience of the last 6 weeks. whether it's the state land board or the county commissioners, they can only rule on the information in front of them. I'll say that again. They can only rule on what's in front of them. So if we spend 6 weeks standing in front of them saying this is not what we want, and the 1 week we're not there is when that proposal's on the table, that proposal passes. Take a look at the schedules. We've got the links here. If you can make any of those days, if we can even get together as a group and coordinate so that not everybody's attending everything, that's great. But somebody has to be at each of those meetings. And number six there, that's if you've got questions, whether it's something we presented tonight, a rumor you heard, something you heard in the local paper, if you want to check it, we will do our best to provide information on it from our giant notebook. If the information is there, we're more than happy to share it. So savemcarthurgulch@gmail.com is the email. A few of the organizations that have already submitted letters are in this room. I'm not going to put them on the spot, but I would like to offer them, 5 minutes or so in our agenda to stand up if they would like to speak. So at this time, I'll put a call out to them and just wave your hand if you'd like to come up here a minute. Sure, Jeff, come on up. And Jeff, don't be offended. I'm not going to try to cut you off, but just so that everybody can speak, feel free. And I may just wave at you in 5 minutes. Sound good?
Hi, everybody. My name is Jeff. I'm the owner of Human Movement. Thanks for putting this meeting together. I think what's best is for the opportunity to discuss what's actually happening up here. Just a lot of misinformation.
Speak up a little bit, please.
Just a lot of misinformation, and I'd really like the opportunity for you to ask questions. That's really, I think having everyone here is phenomenal. I wasn't invited to this meeting, surprisingly. It would have made sense to have me here, I believe. I would bring a couple things to the table. One, we put an application in to the state land board for this proposal, which is for the nonprofit. That is the ultimate goal of this whole proposal. We did it after one site visit up here in the wintertime of 2013. And so, as you can imagine, we put everything under the sun in this application. Hence, we asked for an 18-month discovery period to go through and find out what's actually feasible on the property. After we got on the property and realized what we wanted to do, what the impacts would be, there's no way that we would ever bring 10,000 people up on this property or park 5,000 cars up on the property. We realized that immediately. Only we know what the property can actually hold. This is what we do for a living around the entire country. Yes, sir.
Where have you done this before?
Everywhere. Every county in North America. So not North America, in the United States, rather. Sorry.
Projects with having daycare and then having...
No, events.
Okay. Yeah. Have you built projects like this before?
No, we've never built...
So when you said you've done this all over the country...
Yeah, the events I'm talking about. That seems to be the complaint. Okay. So having the nonprofit doesn't seem to be the issue.
The proposal that's in front of the board, though, reflects 10,000 people. It doesn't say we reevaluated it. So are you resubmitting a proposal?
Yeah, that's what happens after the 18-month period, is we say what we actually need to use the land for. But when we had the meeting on August 8th, that's it. We clarified all of that. Everything is on record during that August 8th meeting. And subsequently, we went and talked to Pam and Myron, who I thought were very kind people. My wife and my 2-year-old son ran around, my 2-year-old son ran around their house while we sat there and talked. And we communicated to him and said, under no circumstances am I going to make a decision to make you upset with me. We're going to be neighbors for hopefully the next 30 years. I want you to be on our board. Myron, I want you to be up there with the kids and tell them about the property, because I think it is a beautiful property that should be shared with the public, specifically the K-12 kids. And expressed everything I'm saying here right now to Pam and Myron, that under no circumstances would we ever have an event that size on that property. It'd be damaging to the property.
Not to be disrespectful. But
no, not at all. That's what I'm here for. Yeah.
I went to a similar meeting like this for Walmart.
Yeah.
And I have a Walmart on my corner. Because what was in writing and what they were saying are two different things.
You say you've been in every county, what, except for ours across North America?
We've been in this, we've put events on here already.
And when on this front here, it says your mission is to make your weekends effing awesome. Is that effing standing for the curse word?
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's a class act, isn't it?
Yeah, how you
wanted here.
That's not our type of community here, sir. That is not, you know, that kind of language. There's high school here. We have kids here. And you stand there so proudly as if saying that, you know, that's something that is acceptable. It's not acceptable.
It's
not about our children, not your beer drinking. I read on your site that you came up to this idea because of the movie The Great Lebowski. That's what moved you, is drinking beer and not getting up and not working. And, you know, this is not something that is really flattering to our community, where we get up and we work hard every day and try to raise our children.
So if you want to take a dig at me, that's great. So I'm from a very, very poor family from Detroit, Michigan. My dad worked for 34 years.
I'm from a farming community.
Yeah. Sir, please.
You told us. I said that. Yeah. You were from a farming community.
Absolutely.
You would never drive across the hay meadow. You liar.
What are you? Myron, please.
No.
So you guys, and I,
no.
So I built this company.
You are a liar.
Myron, please.
Again. We're going to try to keep this information. And
so I built this company with my own money, with absolutely no support on my own, and employ 100 people. So if you don't think I work hard,
yes, you've got a silent partner.
We do now, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, that's not your own money. You got a silent partner, and he likes to spend money on ridiculous things like this. You know, just to go watch girls roll around in the mud.
Great education for
Kate. By the way, what's up with that lawsuit in West Virginia against you guys?
Great. Glad you brought that up. Would you like me to answer it?
Honestly, if you could.
Yes, please.
Be careful, because his wife and 2-year-old in here, he assured me he only doesn't lie if they're present.
Okay, well, I got my boots on, you know. So. Yeah, what's up with that? I mean, how many can we expect here?
You
how many officers can we expect here down the road after you leave the venue if something goes wrong?
You like me to answer the question?
Please do.
If anyone's following the news today, the last 24 hours, you've probably seen me on every news channel in Denver, every radio station in Denver, because last weekend, an event promoter canceled an event. He took in over $200,000 in revenue for the Boulder Marathon. On August 5th, or October 5th, this company canceled it. Walked away with the money, stole these people's money. And I stepped up and said, under no circumstances are we going to allow someone to do this, especially in our state. And so we stepped up, we've got the community support from so many people, and to put this event on with our money for free for these people.
But isn't that exactly what you did in West Virginia?
So I'm getting
to
that.
Take the money and not return it?
Thank you for bringing up West Virginia.
That's
so
where we
West,
started.
I know, I'm saying, I'm getting to that right now. So in West Virginia, our company was hired by a company called 100 LLC that owned the Dirty Girl Mud Run. They stopped paying us in early May, and we went through and kept putting on these events that 100 LLC took the money from these ladies, did not pay the breast cancer charity, and walked out with the money. Did the exact same thing this guy in Boulder is doing this right now as we speak. So our company stepped up and said, we'll pay for this. We'll pay the Breast Cancer Foundation, and we'll make sure that these women have an event. And that's exactly what we did.
Is that what happened last month when we had the one scheduled up here, you had to move the lyrics?
No, we never had an event scheduled up here.
Yeah, there's hold on.
Yeah.
Hold on.
There was an original plan to be up here. Yes, there was an original plan.
There
was an original plan to have an event up here at one point, but it was always scheduled for Erie. We never took in registration for it.
No, you're wrong there, because... I'm the fire chief of Black Canyon Fire, and I would have never found out about it unless my wife wanted to sign up to run it.
Mm-hmm.
And she asked where the HMF ranch was and where Moreland Road was. And just asking about the event. And
all over to different school districts, to charities, the schools, sports programs.
What percentage do you give?
It depends on which kind of event. Typically 2.5% of gross.
You can give us some specifics.
Gross like 500,000 and you get 14?
Yeah, yep.
That's
hey,
great.
Jeff.
It is pretty.
What experience do you have in running a nonprofit organization?
I have zero, but we have a board.
Zero experience, so that's an effing great thing.
Look, that's why we have a board. That's why we have the group of people who are assembling right now that have tons of experience running these.
That's all the carny cabs, right?
Can you point to a model where you've done the daycare before?
No, I cannot.
So your company has no experience in doing this.
I have no personal experience doing this.
Are you familiar with ADA and everything that will be involved in doing this?
Yes, we have people, attorneys on our board that are
familiar
with doing this.
I'm not concerned about attorneys. I'm concerned about people being able to do this and put the project together and maintain it.
Absolutely, 100%.
You have experience doing
this? Yes, 100%.
How long would it
be? You're asking me if I have experience, and I said no. You're asking if this group has experience, I'm saying yes.
Who are they? Why isn't it in the proposal? Who are they?
This
give
is
us
part of
name.
The discovery. This is part
discovery
of the discovery.
Who is an expert at running a daycare is not part of the proposal.
What the state land board approved August the 8th is totally different from what you're talking right now. So that's another reason for the state land board to put it to one side and start the whole process over in a proper manner.
Ask him to rescind the lease and start over.
I moved up here a few months ago from town to get away from everybody.
Yeah.
I actually work right down the street from your building.
I was playing this water.
And I didn't know how you would feel if you lived up here and had to wait to get home from work every day. I had to drive 6 hours just to get home from Louisville the day before 4th of July. For one day, it took me 6 hours. So if you're bringing everybody up here and people who have to commute down the hill can't get home to their families.
Not even commute on a weekend. It takes us 10, 15 minutes to get on the highway to go to Bailey.
Every day, 4 days a week, I drive to Louisville.
And this is the same thing I told Pam and Myron in their kitchen. Is that the last thing we want to do is if we cause a negative impact on this community, what's the point? Why would we be here?
There's places way out in Park County you could do all kinds of stuff. You're not going to affect the community with all of us on a two-lane dirt road. There's plenty of places out there. Why do you have to pick this? Look around you.
You're hurting our businesses, sir. You are hurting business. You are going to hurt all of our businesses in this community. You're the only one profiting. You're the only one. You and your two-year-old that you speak about, talk about being poor. That has nothing to do with anything, okay? You are going to make everyone up here, as this lady brought up. We can barely get out as it is right now. Our emergency personnel are what we have up here, and now they all, what are we going to do? What are our men going to do? Go save you guys up there from drinking yourself to death? Because you said, sir, this came about by you drinking in your underwear, sitting around. And now you want our guys and our men who move up here who have little pay to come and save you while you and your people drinking themselves and drugging and whatever the else they're doing?
You're not saying factual things. It's not,
I am.
It's not fair.
Awesome.
This is not a fair attack. When I'm up here trying to tell you what our intentions are, and I'm saying we don't want to be a negative member of the community, and if you think that we negatively impact businesses when I'm a small business owner,
Jeff, redo your lease. Rescind it and start over again and tell us the truth the next time.
It's so clear. The thing is,
because the first time you didn't tell the truth to the land board. You're telling them all these things that got us all upset. Okay? So rescind this lease, give it up, and start over again with the truth.
We're not giving up. This is the 18-month process. We're following due process. And I'm sitting here in front of the community. I have no reason to come up here, by the way, to have this meeting. I respect that you guys are having these meetings. Do you want me to leave right now?
It wouldn't bother me at all.
Jeff, you've got some additional questions on the side here. Remember, this is informational. All of these questions you have, Dan, be sent directly to the land board rather than Jeff.
I have a question. Let's about get some questions. The comment that you made, I want to clarify.
Sure.
You said you made application to the land board in 2013.
We started the application process in 2013.
The land board, and there were two existing leases on this property at the time that were still good for another 4 years. The minutes of the land board say that the land board approached you for purposes of potential synergies. Mm-hmm. How did it happen that the land board approached you?
We've had this project in mind for 5 years.
I didn't answer my question.
Yeah.
The question is, how and who on the land board approached you for purposes of disrupting existing leases?
Well, two things. One, the existing lease was on the market for the last 10 years. So they're trying to sell it. The Stits are actively trying to sell this and transfer it. And it could have gone to something obviously much worse.
My question is a simple one.
That's a very good point, Ross.
My question is a simple one.
Yeah.
How and who on the land board asked you for the application?
Sure, the staff members.
Who?
Greg, Abe, Chris, all of them.
Are they all friends of yours?
No, I've never met them before.
So they unilaterally approached you?
Yeah.
We
met them at a function, and that was the genesis of this whole thing. We've had this proposal for a long time.
What function?
Yeah, it was a birthday party.
A birthday
party. For like the benefit of needy kids, you know, that's how you come off as I'm going to help benefit K through 12. What's the quantity or as many kids as you're going to put up there? And what's your real plan? Can you give us a plan?
Right.
Like cabins out there? Tell us what you really want to do.
Yeah, that's great. I'd love to answer that question, Bart. the concept was originated from the Leadville mountain bike race when I was at the start line of that race. I looked around. I saw it was a bunch of wealthy, older, white mountain bikers that said they were all after the going after this belt buckle to say that they conquered this Leadville 100 thing. And I sat there and I was looking at it, and it dawned on me, if this can make some of these people that have, you know, tons of years on our at-risk youth, make them feel proud and let them have a sense of purpose to get this belt buckle, what would happen if we offered this up to 10-year-olds on the same kind of concept, where we bring these kids? I think that's really unfair.
Let's really be respectful.
Yeah. Make
sure and stay respectful. This is informational.
You had a question that's been over here for a while.
Yeah,
so keep overlooking.
Yeah,
go ahead.
Sure.
I just want to know, if you've been playing this for so long, why wasn't the community part of the plan?
This is it. I mean, this is part of it. That's why that whole 18-month window.
But if this is it,
5 years, 18 months.
We were community organized this meeting, and you weren't invited, which was probably an oversight, but how can you stand there and say that this is it when you've been
this
doing
is the beginning of the process. I mean, this is an 18-month process of us figuring out if this is even feasible.
But that's after it's granted, right?
No.
So you're ending two leases before that.
The Stits are trying to sell the property, and this, once that property is sold, their lease is over, right? And that's what they're attempting to do right now.
And so, Parks and Wildlife? When does their lease end?
Parks and Wildlife has, I forget what the stats are, they have a great relationship with the state land boards. This is a small piece of it anyway, but I have no idea what their situation is.
So it's safe to say they're pretty upset with this as well?
I can't answer for the Parks and Wildlife. Yeah, go ahead.
I just want to sort of answer your question, because I independently had the same, I'm with the Flume on Walter Newton. I independently had the same question that you had, as far as when I looked at the land board minutes from the August 8th meeting. I had the same question. Who from the land board, how did this synergy happen? Because my first thought, maybe like yours, is do they have friends? What's going on here? Independently from what Jeff just said, I received an answer from the land board. I have a lot of emails from the state land board that even this organization don't have in their packets of my sources, answering the question independently of what the answer that Jeff just gave you with the same answer, okay? So it was the state land board and it was people like Greg Orchis and other people on the staff of, the, of that particular group that reached out to HMF, okay? And that's it. I'll just give you an independent.
Walter, I understand you can't reveal your sources, but would you be willing to share that information with us, even if you don't reveal your sources?
Sure.
That'd be much appreciated.
Yeah. As a matter of fact, I have been sharing. Can I have just a few minutes with the group?
Have you ever had any racist in Louisville?
I guess
Jeff, I don't want to cut your informational time short.
No, that's fine.
But are you okay with Walter?
Yeah.
I just have one question. You said that you've been doing this for trying to get it going for were you approached 5 years ago? I'm sorry.
This has just been a vision. This has been something we've been thinking about for a long time.
In this area?
Without us.
Anywhere. I mean, it could have been anywhere.
Well,
okay, so it wasn't necessarily just Park County that you had this vision.
Right.
Okay.
When you do your donations really quick, do you give that $14,000 to local community nonprofits, or do you give them to whoever you get a whim to give them to that month?
There's no whims, but it's whoever we're associated with in that typically in that district.
So even though we have 26 kids in our nonprofit who all need state funding, even though we live 5 miles down the road, we may not see a dime of that, even though it's 5 miles from our front door.
No, that's not true. No, if you guys came to us and told us what you were up to, absolutely. This is what we've done, and we have a great track record of doing that. And this is once we meet people and we hear their stories, and if they have a great nonprofit, this is what we do. So
give us some specifics, Jeff.
I'm going to step in here
some
a minute.
Specifics about
we've got.
I'm going to let Walter.
We've got Walter who's trying to make a press deadline. We do have time set aside for additional questions and comments. And Jeff, I hope you stick around for that.
Yeah,
I've got some hard questions for him.
Okay. Just,
I mean, they need to be said.
We've got a lot of time here.
Okay,
unfortunately,
I'm say it.
Okay.
First of all, you're doing a commercial development. That's what you're doing. You have not gone through the process through the county to develop that land. You being from Boulder County, you have not done it. You love environmental impact statements. You have not done that. You have not gone through the planning commission to develop this. You have not brought commissioners to develop that piece of land. You have not rezoned it to a commercial piece of property. That has to be done before you can do anything. You're going to go through the same thing that every developer in this entire county has to go through. And I'll guarantee it, because I'll see to it that you have to go through that same process.
Can I just ask one thing? If you've known about this and you've been trying to do it for 5 years and wanting to be a part of our community, why hasn't the community heard anything about it in 5 years?
Like I just said, it was an idea that we've been working on for 5 years. Simply that, an idea, a goal, a passion of ours. It could have been anywhere. That's why. And
so
we went
what was
process.
The idea? The daycare or the 10,000 race? If you've been working on it for 5 years and trying to figure out, what is it that
it's
you've
just,
been working on?
I don't know. I'm not going to start calling it the daycare because it's not what we refer to it as. The nonprofit, the camp.
So which is it? You've been working on that for 5 years.
Yes.
Yet you submit a proposal for a commercial race
venue. Where will the kids come from?
Denver Public Schools.
Did you talk to Denver Public Schools?
Nope.
Does that compete
with
their
already existing?
That's a big. You've been working on this for 5 years. How have you not talked to Denver Public Schools?
I understand. Listen, if you guys are looking for a witch hunt here, and
no
you guys are creating one.
No, I think the camp's amazing.
Okay, so let me just get something straight. A guy with an idea to raise money for nonprofits for kids. And I'm going through the steps right now, and I have made it through the very first step of this nonprofit. The very first step is find this property and go through a discovery phase with the state land board. That is step. Hey, hold on a second. Step number one was this, and then I go on, and then we go to the Denver Public School next, and then we go to whoever's after that. We file all the paperwork. That is the appropriate steps to take.
No,
and
not.
If you guys want to shoot that down, it's on your shoulders.
You can't say Denver kids are coming up if you haven't even talked to them yet. You haven't even talked to them. You just said.
Did you just hear what I said, ma'am? This is part of the process.
My kids
I feel like we're going to.
daycare, get on the street. They're not going to bus them up here.
So your process is going to take Walter. Maybe 20 years?
Yes, potentially. Yep, but that's what it takes.
I have some questions. I'm with the Flume, like I started to say, and we are actually going to try to get a quick sidebar about this meeting into this week's issue. Therefore, I have some questions for basically Pam and Ross, okay? I mean, I've got a lot of information. This is only going to be a short sidebar.
Walter, we're more than happy to answer your questions, but if they're personal opinions of Pam or I, that is better suited for either a press conference or an interview. Okay.
Okay. Earlier you said that this packet contained all the information you have up to just recently.
No. Okay. Abbreviated information based on what we have. What we have to date.
No, I know that packet. Okay. I guess what I'm saying is there's nothing in this packet that contains an opposite point of view.
Why would we do that?
Wait a second. I'm asking these questions are for Jeff. I mean for Pam and Ross. Okay.
Sure.
Because they are the ones that are chairing this. Okay, so I have a question. There was a 1,200 word Flume article that contained replies from the state land board to me that I related to the public with questions I put to the state land board, and that appeared in the Flume article. It was their explanation as to some of the things that are happening. There was also input in that article from HMM. Mm-hmm. This packet does not contain that 1,200 word article. In fact, it was the first article the Flume ever did on this subject. Okay? Yeah. Secondly, the packet doesn't contain a reply from the state land board to the Platte Canyon school superintendent, where they explained to the superintendent and gave him an answer to the letter that you all basically formed for the, sure. And that information is public, it's available, everybody's had it. There's no input in here from Jeff Suffolk, and like I say, there was information in that 1,200 word article with Jeff explaining some of these things, some of the things that have come up tonight. Okay, and I don't see any input in here from Austin Stiff, who wants to get rid of this land from what I gather, and she has a personal interest in this going through. So I'm just curious if this packet is supposed to be informational. There seems to be some information missing.
I'll go ahead and answer that.
Okay.
So the letters you're talking about that went to the county and went to the school or the school board say that decisions will be made by the county. In your packet, there is a letter that says the county has made their decision and they are not going to build roads. They are willing to look at Jeff and his team's.
That's not what I asked. Why wasn't this 1,200-page Flume article included in here and a lot of supportive stuff that I've sent to
people? How many in here get the Flume?
Hold on. We're not a public information
organization. There's a Flume article in here. There's a Flume article in here.
We've already seen
the second Flume article. Yeah.
Right. And I'll answer your question. We're not a public information organization. We're a community that's coming together. And the information we've been able to include in the packet is the information we've been able to get. Jeff and his team have been on social media saying they will hold town halls, and I really hope that they do.
Absolutely.
Okay.
But that's not our responsibility to put out his information.
It's not my responsibility to put out his information either.
Sure.
I've never met Jeff. So will you admit that there's nothing in here from the opposition?
I have not met opposition yet.
State land board's in there. They're what they get on the
state land. State land board is it's explained themselves already. And tomorrow, by the way, if anybody wants to go to the Board of County Commissioners meeting, the state land board will be at the Board of County Commissioners meeting to explain. The state land board will be there to explain their processes and how this kind of thing comes down, just in case the Board of County Commissioners need
That's
a refresher. Okay, but I'm just saying, none of the replies from the state land board explaining their position is in here.
Is the paper taking a position on this?
No, the paper isn't taking a position on this.
It sounds like it has.
Well, no, it hasn't. If you read the article, you read three articles? Anybody think there was a position
right here.
In the first article?
In the first one?
Yeah.
Are we going to go through
No,
each
no,
other?
No, I mean, we don't... No, no, I don't want to go through your article. He just accused the paper of taking. No, the paper is not taking a position. That's the answer.
Let's carry on. Okay.
Let me try sales. Jeff, will you be sending out additional information?
Yes.
There's his informational packet.
Okay. Does that answer?
And if he sends additional information to you and Pam, will you send it out to the email list? I mean,
why not?
I'm not asking why not. I'm asking will you?
Absolutely. Okay. Everybody sure. That puts their email on that form, if Jeff gives me information, you guys will get it.
Can I ask something there?
Absolutely.
Why wasn't it put in there that I offered Myron a position on our board and I said I wouldn't make any decisions without his permission?
Because it's not ready.
And honestly, why would you offer one member of our community a position on your board
after meeting us for 5 minutes?
At the time, Myron and Pam were the only ones that said they had concerns with it.
You never knocked on my door.
Nobody else knew. Jeff.
I live across the street.
We were the only ones that knew.
You're the one that doesn't mind putting your wife and child. Right?
Myron, what am I?
Come here. Come here. Talk to me about it.
Let's keep it going.
Keep it moving.
Jeff, would you like to make a final 5-minute?
Ross, I'd reject
that. I'm just really here to answer questions.
It's two quick points.
Yes, go ahead.
Okay. Yeah, I have two quick points. One's legal and one's human. And I'm going to address this to you, Jeff. I've been justified by legal counsel that by itself it is against the law to enter into any kind of a contract in a clandestine manner. That means a secret manner. And I promise you, everything I've heard, everything I've read, talked to Pam, your entire process is in a secret, clandestine manner. Number two, when I was working on my doctorate at Haight-Ashbury, we had a major study done on human population. And you probably don't know this, but out of a group of 100 people, 10% are marginally neurotic, psychotic, or marginally so. And so if you get these for-profit people up there, and all the various activities, you have anywhere from 100 to 1,000 people who are marginally neurotic, psychotic, in that area of behavior, just a human probability. Now, who's going to take care of all these crises? If you have a counselor, if you have a psychologist, who's the medical care? Who's going to take care of these human sides of people? Why, somebody's making a lot of money. Ten to 20%. You can look it up for yourself.
Jeff, do you want to handle that?
And neither one of those points were relevant.
Oh, pardon me.
You do know about the made by day law, right?
If you guys want to say that this was clandestine, that this whole application process was clandestine, you have to take that up with our governor then, because we followed the letter of the law all the way through.
Governor!
Please.
We'll let you in there.
But if you're calling me clandestine, I find offense to that. All we did was follow due process, and that's all I'm doing now. I came to your meeting to answer your questions as a citizen of Colorado, and this is how you guys want to treat me.
Community.
Yeah, what was irrelevant there, about what that
ma'am,
means?
Ma'am,
I
think you've had enough.
People being
Susie,
that is a statistic.
Susie, what was your question?
My question is, how come you are coming up to the mountains for this?
Yeah.
It's a large group of people, probably really fun. You know, there's probably athleticism, community stuff happening. I'm not saying that everything around it is a negative thing, but it doesn't really belong in a mountain setting.
No.
And you're hearing a lot of feedback, but people don't want it in this setting.
The
events. And if you want to help the marginal communities around the periphery with the proceeds, that's great. But, you know, people are up here because they want to be up here, not because they want the roads crowded and they want the land marred and, you know, these things. And I really feel like you have to respect what you're hearing.
Right.
And if you did it in Denver, in Louisville, in Boulder County, it's set up so much better. It has all everything that you're being asked. It's already there.
Yep.
The infrastructure's there. Just respect what people are asking of you and
100%.
Have your fun and do the wonderful things where it's appropriate. This is an inappropriate setting.
Would you be in favor of if we were able to host the events down in Denver but fund the nonprofit up here?
Yeah, you do it every month.
We can't see you have to fund it, that's your choice.
We can't see what you actually want to do.
Just, I think the community, that's do it in not an urban setting where you're not impacting the people. More people can join in, they can enjoy it. You're not, you know, you're overwhelming. You know, that people, I don't think these people are any different than the next mountain community, the next mountain community. I don't want to go chasing your next venue. But you are hearing loud and clear, people don't want it. And people do want your activities, they're well attended, but do it where, don't, you know, make people spend, you know, $15 in gas and pollute the environment and, you know, not have the infrastructure set up.
Right.
Do it where you already have that. It's not going to, you still get your business plan met, people get to have their fun.
Right.
I don't understand why you're...
Yeah. I'm not pushing back on that at all. I totally agree with you, Susan. That's how I led the meeting. That's how I started it off. And that was the original conversation I had with Pam and Myron and I'm having with everybody here. I completely agree with you on that. And that's why I just think there's misnomers. There's no chance that we would do this. That is exactly what I said at the state land board meeting.
Fight over the numbers. I mean, you know, this is a small community. 285 isn't a huge road. You know, I mean,
wait. And there's no chance you'll do it, but your proposal is all about it.
Yeah.
So I don't understand. You came up,
right?
Right.
I will. Yes, TJ. That is. And then we've talked to the state land board about it. Absolutely. There just needs to be clarification, and just like anything, just needs to be communication.
Well,
we don't need to withdraw it. That's what the whole 18 months is.
Just change it as it goes, right?
We can go back and revisit it and say, this is our proposal. We have to go through Park County and say, these are the events. If we were to ever hold events up here, these are the events that we'd want to host. And they could deny it or they could approve it. But again, the whole point is not to ruffle the feathers of community. Like, the last thing you want to do is come up here and not be welcomed or be able to sit in your restaurants or have a cup of coffee with you. Like, that, who wants that? Like, what would be the point of that?
So you would talk to RMIG and Wendy Pease and Denver and all the other ones that have people who have gone through the whole process of having here.
Yeah, I think Susie's making great progress though with this question, and I think that it brings to light what I'm trying to get to is that this is all discovery. This is the whole point of this, and this is why I came up here to say that is that under no circumstances do we want to make your roads bad. We're not going to take taxpayer money for anything. That's not.
Why don't you stay in the city?
What's that?
Why don't you stay in the city? How come you're trying to come up here?
To do the nonprofit?
To do your whole venture. Why don't you find an area in the city to do it?
We don't want to expose the kids to state land that's owned by the state.
They have other opportunities to get up to state land. You know, they're at Windy Peak, they're at Mount Evans.
We got your she's down here. That's for underprivileged kids.
You know,
we got another place up the road for underprivileged kids here already.
You're not talking about that many kids, really. You know, I mean, seriously, you're not impacting that many kids' lives.
But what you're talking about is impacting an entire area that has wildlife, that has an amazing habitat.
Do you know what's happening up there right now?
What?
Do you guys know what's happening up there right now?
What's happened up there for 60 years?
Ken?
You know, in this community, in the past, we've had two major disruptions with fires. Both of those fires, the Snaking Fire and the High Meadow Fire, was K-12 kids smoking. It devastated this community not once but twice. And it was high school kids both times.
Not local.
Sure.
I want to hear Snaking Fire.
I know, but you didn't mention the other one.
Oh,
yeah,
I did.
Snaking
and
High
Meadow.
Let's continue to
sheriff and make sure.
You know what? I'll be brief. I think, Jeff, one of the problems is, and I think that I understand some of the things that you're trying to do, and I am, believe me, it's nothing against you yourself. I think what happened is that over the course of this last year, Park County's got screwed three times by folks coming in saying, I'm just going to do this little event, which is literally taxed my department, it's taxed emergency services,
and it's created a lot of hard feelings. You know, I have folks over when we got the South Park Music Festival that didn't know that they were going to have to listen to that music all night, you know, and the thumping and pictures falling off the wall because the bass is so loud. So I think one of the things, and I'm going to hold it to this. You said that you'd be interested in public input. I think that that's probably the most important thing through this whole process is you need to sit down and listen to everybody, listen to what we're going to have to put up with. We don't have a lot of money. I don't have a tax base that's huge here in Park County. All I have is property tax. I have nothing else. So everybody's taxed. Businesses that I have businesses that are falling apart all the time that can't afford to stay here. El Rio's changed hands about 8 times. I mean, you know, it's disappointing because I've been here 40. Oh, that's a long time. I've been here a lot. And you know what? It's, you know, when you see this, we love our community. There's a reason we live here. The peace, the quiet, the tranquility.
Yes, correct.
And I really want you to think about that. Mm-hmm. You know, I've been lucky enough to be sheriff, and I've enjoyed the relationship I've had. But you know, one of the things that we worry about is the fact that 285 has not had any growth. Mm-hmm. And right now, over this last year, I have all the traffic in the world that has decided to go up and down 285. Any more disruption to that, we have to start looking at turn lanes to put in. I have to pave roads. I mean, there's a lot of things. And where does that money come from?
Well, doesn't CDOT say that on weekends we're 140% of capacity?
Yes, we are.
That's already.
Yes, we are.
That's right.
Correct.
You couldn't handle the leaf washers.
And you know, one of the things my concern is that I realize that we have a governor that has all the answers, but I, you know what? That's been. I have to worry about here. And so I really, please, pay attention to what folks are saying.
Absolutely.
I think it'll help you out. Mm-hmm. If you really want to concern yourself about what's going on here, mm-hmm. listen to our community. Thank you.
Thanks, Jeff.
Can I just ask a couple of questions on the timeline?
On which timeline? On the proposal timeline?
How this all transpired. Jeff said you were been looking for 5 years. So you told the state land board that you wanted to do this 5 years ago?
No.
4 years ago? Just last
year.
Huh?
Just last
year. Last year. And when did they tell you they found the thing? They approved it in a matter of weeks or a couple months.
I'm sorry, I couldn't hear. I'm sorry, Jeff. What did you say?
He was asking what the timeline was, how long the land board has been able to look at this, and it's approximately 9 months. And that's why they've taken the extra 18 months.
So they have almost immediately found you the property.
Yeah, we looked at a few properties in Park County. State Land Board has a lot of properties.
I'm not even opposed to kids thing per se. I think that's a great thing. But now, are you going down my road? I can't let my kids out of the house. I can't let my dogs out of the house. We have to leave for the weekend because we're not going to listen to you or put up with it. I mean, we'll leave.
Won't you chuck just open the desk?
My house is such a giant dirt bucket. So having all those cars.
You can think about us, not just
yourself. Yeah, the kids say I get it.
I know you guys don't want to believe me. That's I don't. Like, I wouldn't be here right now, but I didn't want to hear yet.
I just
want
to keep it a cool
now. You know what
they say. And don't keep coming in the back door.
Make one of these.
Not me coming in the front door and be truthful.
That's all we ask. Just tell us what's going on.
Tell us the truth.
You know,
yeah.
That's all we want.
Yeah.
your question for us or for Jeff or both?
All we heard when he was up there is he'll be denying what we've all been told is going to happen is going to happen. Do we have 5-10 minutes for him to tell where he would amend that? That's number one. Number two, my understanding in this is very limited as far as the land board goes. But if this proposal is what's on the table, and you're saying that that's not in fact what you're planning to do, at what point before they accept here, do we get to see the full plan? Do they get to see the full plan? Because to say, well, that was our plan, but I tell you, we're not doing it. If they go ahead and accept it, we're laced in.
So the land board operates under their rules, their regulation.
Well, that's for sure.
So they can, they can approve it as it is right now, and Park County could approve the events as they are right now as well. And I'm standing here in front of you, knowing that both of those two things could happen, and we could get our way up here. Right then and there, and that's why I'm standing here in front of you.
But is there no way, Jeff, that you could amend this so that they and you and all of us have the peace of mind of knowing what is the actual, not what could, and you're saying it won't. But, you know, I don't know you from Adam. And frankly, I'm not really impressed with someone who says, gee, I've made all these big bucks and everything else, and I give 2% to the nonprofit. That doesn't blow me out of the water. I don't donate to groups like that.
Actually, I know that's actually like touches me really closely, because you guarantee the difference is we guarantee 2% of gross. Like I've been unprofitable lots of years, but even with that, we guarantee 2% of our gross. Where other organizations would say a portion of the proceeds or 50% of profit. Like what does profit even mean? Like those are the groups you have to look out for. At least I stand in front of it. It's a lot of money for a small company to say, I wonder if I only profit 3%. Almost my entire profit goes back to charity, which I'd be happy I had done.
But is there a point in all this before the land board stamps this with approval that it's nailed down as to what it actually will be? Because I'm going to fight this tooth and nail.
Sure.
But if it came through it and all of your, we changed our minds. If all that's nailed down and we all get to see it before it goes too far, wouldn't that benefit every one of us?
Absolutely.
What you're saying,
I just want to make sure it's clear. Like, I'm not backing down off the nonprofit and our plans up there for the cabins.
But are you backing down off of 10,000 people?
I honestly believe that that was taken from historical saying that we have produced events with 10,000 people.
But
we won't clarify that. So like,
but before simply, the land board goes,
we have 75 people up here. You know, this doesn't even work for that many people. So,
right.
Yeah.
But before the land board goes, oh yeah, we trust this and it's really not going to be that way. When you stood up here tonight, oh no, it's really not going to be that way. Well, I'm sorry, I don't know you well enough to make
that. That's what the next phase of this 18-month period is all about. And that's simply the process. And that's what you'll hear tomorrow morning. That's why we designed it this way.
Here's the meeting.
Yeah.
Will I see it in a minute? Will the land board see it and sign it?
Have to see it.
So it can't change again?
So if the land board approves this, and you know the community doesn't want this, will you still move forward?
Sure. Doesn't want what?
Doesn't want any of this going on here.
Just simply don't want the charity, the nonprofit, even if it benefits her charity.
Okay, the difference between that, I don't think that the issue is with the charity. I don't think that is what is it is. It's what you're going to have to do in our community to support that. And by no means am I saying don't do the charity. By no means am I saying that. And I realize that you have to do things to support a nonprofit. Trust me, I realize that. But what we're saying, just like this gentleman, this lady here said, I'm looking at him, what she just said is, you know, I believe that these are probably super awesome. I'm not going to go to them, as you can see. But these are probably amazing. They're probably super fun. And I'm all about going and having a margarita after. I'm not saying that these are not amazing things. And I'm not saying that you haven't built yourself up with nothing. And to say that you're going to donate 2%, even if your profits are only 3, that's awesome. And I commend you for that as well. That is amazing. I'm not, like, I don't know you from Adam either. And I'm not saying that you're a bad business person. What I'm saying is, as a community here, I've lived here my entire life, as a community, being able to come and talk to the community. If you found the property 9 months ago, why didn't you come down and put up something saying, hey, I'd like to meet you? Why haven't we seen you? And why haven't we heard about this until I go and I look for a property and I hear about this? You know, that's
yeah.
that's how I found out of it. And I feel like it's being it's not, maybe not even shut down our throats, but more like, this is going to happen. I'm not saying that your charity is not one that's not awesome. Even if it is only, you know, 50 to 100 kids a week in the Denver public school area, that's great. But what about all the other, what about Jefferson County? What about Clark County? You know, what about the other counties here? Why not have, you know, other things? My concern is that what he's saying is, you know, if they say this is it, are we going to, because in your proposal, it's right here, it's underlined right here, on your Colorado State Board of Land Commissioners, on page 3, right here, event you're raising an outdoor event, AMM estimates group between 10 to 1,000 participants. And what she's saying is, even though it's written down here, and you do have an 18-month discovery period, are you going to write it down knowing that Clark County can't handle that? We as a community don't want that. We're a small community. We come here for peace and quiet. We've lived here with that. That's what our concern is.
I'm going to go ahead and cut it off here. Jeff, if you'd like to continue talking with people, absolutely do so. We're starting to lose people, so I want to draw it to a conclusion here. It sounds like, Jeff, we need more information. If you can give it, I want you to have a dialogue with whoever you want to have it, but we're starting to lose people, so I want to make sure we get all the information out there. Mackenzie back here has a petition if you're ready to sign it today. As Walter pointed out, we kind of know where I stand. I want to see it in writing. I hope Jeff will give it to us in writing and amend it as he sees necessary. In the meantime, feel free to email us if you have additional questions. If Jeff gets us additional information, we'll get it to you as well. Thanks for coming tonight,
everybody. Thank you so much.